happened to be in bookstore, I may as well share that I run Scarce Publications, which does two literary magazines. Down in the Dirt magazine, the CC&D magazine, and each magazine comes out every month as a 6x9 perfect bound paperback book that is sold through Amazon. So I'm always honored to be able to come here and show the brand new books that have come out. And from CC&D magazine, the book is titled Question Everything. And the titles are usually generated from one piece of accepted writing from books. Somewhere in there is a piece called Question Everything, and that's after returning very recently from a trip to Antarctica for Thanksgiving. I have so many beautiful images, and so you may see a couple of Down in the Dirt with an Antarctica photo as well. So yeah, that was it was amazing. So it was. From CC&D magazine, I was going to share one haiku that appears in here and then a few other things. I've explained to Tom before that oftentimes when
the space of the bottom of the
page. People have a piece of prose.
Okay, cool.
As you can see here, if I've got artwork that would take a lot of space, you have artwork or something at the end of prose. Otherwise, I'll just cram a little haiku in there and fill that off. And this one is actually called Don't. Don't drink the water. Never show legs or shoulders. Or go out at nights alone. That was about being a woman living in India. Mm-hmm. After visiting there, I realized, oh, this is why Indian women have leggings underneath their skirts. You have to have your shoulders covered. I went there, it was only high in the 80s, but you cannot dress comfortably. I saw a Muslim woman in black outfits and capes and everything, and the headgear and legging, go swimming in the pool.
Sure.
Yep.
Differences in religion, but yeah, that was just little things I would think for that. But inside CC&D right now, there's also performance art sections, and I will take pieces that were done at a poetry show, and I will have two poems to share for you. From a performance art show, what is that called? This was from, I will tell you, Our Cultural Independence and Achieving Global Freedom. It was done at the Baha'i Center. And these are two poems from this that I'll share with you. And this one's a short one called Zero Stadium. I had to have that tie to you. I would draw your face since we're apart. I need to solve my xerostomia. So finally, when I got the chance, I took your photo in a crowded room. I know I'll never meet you, but I need to have that record of you. I need proof that you were real. This photo is truth. This photo is certainty. I developed the film, dodged and burned out all the people around you, didn't matter, ancillary people, nobodies to me. Started printing your image on my black and white printer. Everything will be so crystal clear when everything's in black and white. They say I need independence from you, but I made more and more prints. I bumped up the contrast, reduced you to mere two-tone prints. I kept printing, kept plastering your image everywhere I could, until all I saw were images of you, and all I saw were replicas of you. And I stared at copies of your face, and I wasn't free. That's when I knew that I forgot the substance of you to me.
And I will just
go on one room with just three poems, but this last one is a long one, so I can take some time for that one. That's all it's going to be in this one, but this one is a piece called, and I should actually, just to let you guys see, I had photos in the show where I was like, I've got photos of you and I'm casting them everywhere, and I was just throwing images around. Might as well use you might as well perform it if you're gonna perform it.
Right?
I have images of you two different things.
I'm stealing some of your chops from you.
So this last one is a longer one, it's called Utopia Never Happened. The last thing I remembered was making a left-hand turn at the car intersection in the middle of nowhere. There was no one for miles, but then suddenly I saw an oncoming car careening straight toward me. All I could do was slam on my brakes and brace for impact. But I woke up in a strange bed, and I could hear, like, health monitors. I think this was a hospital room, but I had no idea where I was.
Thanks for calling.
I was mortified. I rubbed my temple. I felt okay, maybe bruised, so I didn't know why I was here. And the last thing I wanted was doctors that I didn't know telling me that I couldn't leave and leaving me strapped to a layer like a prisoner. I've been trapped like this before. I know that feeling all too well. I just wanted to be free. I worked all my life to gain my independence, to stand up for myself, to do what was right. And there was no way I wanted to be placed in a straitjacket and strapped into a hospital again. I was better than that. I had to be. I rubbed my temple, as I carefully walked toward the closed door, until the door opened. A man saw me and smiled. I'm glad to see you're doing well, he said, smiling. And as I felt my blood begin to boil, I asked, why am I here? And he could tell it from my tone that I shouldn't be reckoned with. So he laid it all out for me. You got away from other people with your car. When you were knocked out from that car crash, the driver from the other side didn't make it, so we flew you here. You see, we watched your work. You've got a lot of talent, and we've seen you fight every single step of the way when you've actually tried to accomplish your own goals. I think you understand how unfair the government can be, and we know that you understand that those with the government's mentality will use any tactic other than reason to stop you as well. So, we thought we would save you from that, where you would be able to work with your mind and be respected again. I stared at him. I'm tapping my toe, apparently. I just stared at him. But I think he actually knew that look in my eyes, and he saw it turn from this indicting stare to this incredulous gaze before I looked away in disbelief. I can tell you're not interested, but others like you around the world got fed up with fighting a system that they couldn't beat. Mm. I had to stop them again. Where am I? Mm. My tone was almost threatening. We flew you to an island that no radar can detect, because here you can work where you can't, or you won't actually be stopped. I was able to work before, I answered. And how many hoops did you have to jump through to actually do it? He answered, which stopped me enough to think about all the fighting that I've gone through in my life and all that I've fought for, and it was usually all to no good. We've seen your work, he started to say, now in a more relaxed tone than before. And because of that, we started an account for you. And for all of the good that you've done that you've never been paid for before. You can stay here with us and with other minds that are open and eager to listen. I stared for a moment, knowing that I was taken here, but wondering if there was any truth to what he was actually saying. And maybe once you see your people here, maybe you'll see that everyone here is worthy of respect. He waited for me to interject. I thought about the goals I've accomplished, and then I thought about how I had to fight to get anything done. I didn't interject. You can stay here as my guest, but I think that you'll look forward to being here on your own. You'll be able to work at what you need to do, and you will be paid fairly for your work. He paused again. But you need rest. Please, sleep, and we'll talk in the morning. And with that, he left the room. I slowly stared down at the bed again. In a way, it sounded like it was a dream come true, being free from the suppressing forces and having true independence to live the way it was meant to live. I rubbed my temple again. As I lay down in bed, I was brought here against my will, was all I could think. But wait a minute. Maybe this could be like an intellectual utopia. All I could think was that...
Christine, your eyes ready? Christine, your mind ready?
All I could think was that my things arrived, sorry. All I could think was that this could be my chance to live with others from around the world that came to this one sacred place where our independent wills actually brought us all together to be smarter, stronger, and more free. I close my eyes. I don't know how long my eyes were closed, but when I opened my eyes, I was in my own bed, and my fingers were still at my temple. I knew this couldn't have been a dream, but here I am. And after I'm sure I heard this man's words, I don't want to believe that this respect, that this freedom, this utopia, I can't believe that all of this, that this... never happened. I want to believe that this respect, this freedom, this independence, that this utopia is just waiting for me to find it. Yeah. Thank you.
Very nice.
And that was all for that, and somebody else came. That was enough of CC&D magazine.
That is awesome.
Thank you. Thank you very much.